All right, man. Introduce yourself, man.
Richie Marciano. She's coming straight from the east side of the town. I don't know what else really to say. I think my name says a lot by itself right there.
All right, man. You just put out your first mixtape, man, last week, man. Let everybody know about it.
Reflections debut mixtape so far, first week. It did good. Just found out it was like good 800 downloads first week, so I'm a little bit proud about that. Put a lot into it. Real soulful, heartfelt, and it's a lot of emotions and feelings. And then I wasn't really afraid to be myself either. There's a lot of topics that I addressed, and that most people probably wouldn't even really speak about in songs. I talked about loss of a grandfather, situation between uncle going to jail or being incarcerated. Even got a song called A Woman's Struggle, where I talk about a girl meeting a womanizer and, you know, really getting screwed over. So it's a lot of topics, and the content is like, it's a little bit different from what you may hear, even though there's other artists out here who have content similar to myself. But to really get the recognition right now, I appreciate it, and I'm thankful for everybody that even took the opportunity to check that out.
All right, man. Now, this being your first mixtape, man, what do you find is the hardest thing about being a recording artist?
What you say?
What's the hardest thing about recording, being a rapper?
Honestly, the hardest thing is just continuing to go over everything and making sure everything is good. Because a lot of people will just go do a song, and with them doing the song, that be it. They don't think about going over their material or even listening to it to really see exactly what they could do different. So I figure most people just figure they just put it out. For me, I try to critique my music. Like, I held on to most of the songs for Reflection for months. Like, I didn't put out any original material until like the beginning of July. But that's because I was going over all the material to make sure that it was A1 and just making sure everything was up to par. And on top of that, I think the hardest thing is in the city gaining listeners. Most people don't want to take the time to listen to most local artists. Because the first thing they think is, here go another local artist, here go another rapper, and they instantly don't want to really hear what you got to say. So the hardest thing for me was the content and making sure the songs are up to par, and just the support system. Like, that's just about the hardest thing that I've had to deal with so far. It kind of took me like a year to get to where I am right now, honestly. So I still got more growing to do, and I might face more difficult tasks, but I think I'm prepared for it.
All right, man. How have the fans been responding to you and your music, man?
A lot of people have responded back to me. They actually like it. I haven't really heard too much negative comments about it, but I've heard majority positive. Most people really like it. Most people consider it a classic. Most people wanted a CD. Honestly, it's just the love that I've gotten over it, like from everything overall, it's been just nothing but amazing. So it seemed like a lot of people mess with it, and I think a lot of people probably would want to expect more from me. So it went good.
All right, man. Now, can we expect any videos for the songs?
It's possible. I'm actually trying to work that out now. If anything, a video will be shot sometime in August and released in the beginning of September. Possible. I'm working on that now. So far, I got a song called Hello. That's strictly for the ladies. And so far, I've seen a lot of people really say they want to see a video for that. So I think that might be in the works.
All right, man. Now, outside of this CD, man, what else do you have out?
I have a brand that I'm working on called Cool Zone. So really, it's just getting that brand up and running. And it's more so Cool Zone is something positive. It's basically about being positive and doing positive things, and I'm trying to use the brand to really use it to give back. So I'm really just trying to figure out ways to increase the brand and then really give back at the same time as it grows. So possibly maybe in the future, fundraisers here and there, the donation, because my original idea at first was to really start the brand and use the brand to really give back, because I had a friend had her first child and the baby had cleft lip. So I was thinking of having a fundraiser to where I raise money and donate to foundations that handle and deal with cleft lip to really give back to that, because that's something that that's real serious, especially having your first child and then they have a cleft lip and then having missing like lips and things like that. So that's one thing that I'm trying to do. But besides that, more music and still cool zone.
All right, man. Now you say on this CD, man, it's real soulful. And you know what I'm saying, man? You got a whole different vibe, man. Coming from the city, man, you don't really see that a lot. Like, how did you create your own? What made you do that? Or is that just the type of music that you do?
Honestly, because when I started out doing music, I had to be about 15. And my direction, it changed often. I didn't know exactly which way I wanted to go. But as I started trying to study music, I studied, like, most music from the 90s and then most current artists that been in the game from the 90s on up, really, and really just listening to their content and then listening to other content and seeing what fits me. Because I'm not the type to really talk about, you know, selling drugs or anything like that. I'm more of a self-spoken type of person. So I'm gonna address situations that I feel like need to be addressed. And I'm gonna talk about, you know, stuff that I like and stuff that I see. I think that fits me more than anything, because anybody can talk about this and then not live that lifestyle. So if anybody listen to my music, they see that the type of music that I give off, like that's my type of lifestyle, like the fun records I have or the conscious stuff. Like I think a lot, so if you listen to it, you can tell that I'm a heavy thinker. So it's just going in that direction.
All right, man. Now, what do you expect to gain out of rap, man?
What I expect to gain? Honestly, I'm still growing, so as I move forward, I expect to gain knowledge as I move forward. Cause I feel like having knowledge, it helps you so much, especially musically, but as a person, and more than anything, I'm big on growing as a person. So I'm just hoping that it can take me everywhere. Like, I actually want to be able to go to other cities, other countries, and really see other cultures, because there's so much you see inside of Detroit. But I think if you had the opportunity to see outside of Detroit and expand your horizons, then I think it'll better me as a person as well. And that's my main thing, is to better myself as a person. So I'm just hoping that I can really better myself. And that's not even related to like materialistic things. That's just seeing outside of what I've seen for the last 20 years.
All right, man. Now, you say you want to try to brand your cool zone.
Right.
Now, is there any other people that's involved in that with you?
Well, with cool zone, right now, I have a friend named Dev Holly. He's in Alabama, but right now, he's on standstill, but we have Dej Loaf. Currently going to work on that, and then after Dej Loaf, it'll possibly be like a Reflections tour. But right now, it's just getting Dej Loaf off the ground right along with myself. So as I grow, she grows. And then as the brand grow, you'll see like everything else around us grow as well. But it's Dej Loaf and Cool Zone. Then I got my producer, Jay Woods. He has CMC. And so far, we have like Nolan the Ninja, Everyday Jay, Thesaurus, which contains Phil Swish and B-Nix. I know all of them have projects on the way too. So I think I just got to give a helping hand to those that have been supportive of Reflections and those who I run with that are like label mates and people a part of Cool Zone and CMC.
All right, man. Now, what's been some of your most memorable moments, man, while you've been creating this CD?
I think most memorable moments is I gotta say the fun things that happen and that take place that's related to music. Like, it's little things that go on in the city that is like little venues. You have like the Air Up Theirs, the Kickbacks, the Red Cups, things like that. Those are by far the most memorable moments, and just what takes place and getting the chance, the opportunity to let people hear my music and then hear what I gotta say, and then actually take the time to support afterwards. And then the people, things that happen afterwards, like people go crazy, like I'm some type of celebrity or something like that. Like, that's kind of memorable, but it's funny. It's just those type of moments I think you remember, but just the people that I come across and touch. I think that's also the most memorable thing for me. There's the people I come across and touch, and those who mess with me musically, because sometimes if people take the time to listen to me musically, they end up saying that they can really see themselves messing with me like as a person. And that's my main thing. I want people to listen to my music and they see my thoughts and they see how I function, and they say, like, I really see how this person functions as a person, and they see that I'm a real genuine person at the end of the day. So I think that's those things that go down as most memorable for me.
All right, man. You say you possibly planning a reflection too, man. Have you got any like date when we can expect it?
I think what I'm gonna try to do is use reflections, one, as anticipation, and really just use that to my advantage between now and possibly early 2012. Like I said, I still gotta worry about everybody else that I'm working with, as in Cool Zone and the people that I work with CMC. Like, I work as a team, so my main focus really is just helping promote Jay's project, Dave's project, Nolan's project, and then everybody else's project. But on top of that, I think my main thing of promoting for it, I have people who want to do features and collabs. So I think I'm going to take advantage of that as well to really help with anticipation for Reflections too. And I think it's really just, like I said, using Reflections 1 as a tool to help benefit for the second time around, which I think would be a little bit bigger and a little bit better. Well, it will be bigger and it will be better. So I think that's what we're going to go with.
All right, man, you got any last words and shout outs, man?
Last words, honestly, would be to come downtown here to like DSC and come down to Freshman, check out these stores. If you look, like, just take the time to look at all the clothing. It's a nice selection. And I really want people to come take the time to really come down here, because this is clothing made by people who took the time to come up with these designs and wake up every morning and open up these stores. And it's like, I want to say it's genuine. It's like, I'm a genuine type person. I like genuine things. So I think like these type of stores, like DSC, Freshman Clothing, it's genuine. I really want people to come downtown and really see like what's going on in the heart of the city. Because most people go out and they see going on out there, but it's a lot of cool stuff and nice stuff down here in the city as well. So I want people to come down here. That's about my last words right there.
They say the sky's the limit. I haven't been there, but I'ma get there in a minute. It's got a smile witness, won't stop until I'm finished. Only one shot, guaranteed I won't miss it. I guarantee I won't miss it. I guarantee I won't miss it. I guarantee I won't miss it. Only one shot, guaranteed I won't miss it. You got a chance of life, better go jump on it. Then being